Now, good morning, how are you doing? Now, today we'll be looking at business studies, and the topic I'll be teaching you today is office correspondence. Office correspondence. Now, this is the outline. I will tell you the meaning of office correspondence, then the types of office correspondence. Now, what do you mean of office correspondence? Now, office correspondence is the what? Is the writing, receiving, and exchange of letters and mails that come in and go out of an office. Look at it again. It's what? It's the writing. That is when an organization writes or receives, okay, an exchange of what? Of mail and letters. Letters. Mail of letters. Can you do that? So you know, sometimes an organization they can write a letter, they can send a letter to a particular organization, and they can also receive letters. Not only letters, mail. You know mail now, that is the electronic letter, sorry. Sometimes you can send a mail to what, a company. Maybe you want to request for something. You can easily what, send it what? You can send it what, through mail, abi? And sometimes an organization can also send you mail. So office correspondence what is what? Is the writing or receiving an exchange of letters and mail that come in and go out. That is, anytime we receive mail or letters from another company, it will be written in the office, abi? It will be written down. And we as an organization or company, we can sell, for example, look at Special Sprouts. Special Sprouts is an organization. Sometimes Special Sprouts can what? Can receive mail or letters from another organization. And sometimes Special Sprouts can what? Can send mail or letters to another organization. So this is what we call office correspondence. Is what? Is the writing, receiving, and exchange of what? Mail and letters that come in and go out of an office. Now let's look at types of office correspondence. Then we have three types of office correspondence. We have inward books. Then we have inward books. We have outward books. We have dispatch book. Then we have postage book. Now let me start with what? Inward books. Now, inward books is what? Is what? Is the book that shows all the letters and mails that's what? That a company receives from other organizations. That we call inward books. So it's a book that shows what? That show all the letters, mails that is received or that comes in from other organization to a particular organization. That is, as a, I mean, this company, as an, let's assume this Special Sprouts is an organization. The, you know, that some companies, some organization, we send mails to Special Sprouts through internet, have you? And sometimes they can send a letter. So all this information, sorry, all these letters and mail received by organization will be what? Will be recorded in what? In inward books. We call it inward books. When we are receiving or we are what? We are receiving letters or mail from other organizations, will be recorded in what? In inward books. Sometimes all the letters received through mail, it will be written down, written inside inward books, through letters, written any letters or what? Or mail we receive from other organizations will be written in inward books. Now, what are the uses of inward books? I wrote it on the board for you. So one of the uses of it is used to by an organization to know the total number of mails and letters received during a period. Now, the reason why we organization normally have what inward books is because at the end of the day, the organization will be able to know the what, to know the total number of mails and letters received by an organization in a what, in a particular period. It can be yearly or monthly. How many letters and mails do we receive this during this month? You can check your inward books. So is this one of the uses of inward books? It is used by an organization to know the total number of mails and letters received during a period. And the second one is what? It is used to know the details of mails reduced. That is, you know, that number one, the first use of inward books is what? To know the total number of mails and letters we receive. The second one is what? It is used to know the details of mails we see. That is, the details. Letters we receive, Abi, what is the content of the letter? What is it telling you? What is the information behind the letter? So, we want to know the total information. We can also use what to know the total information. The details of that what? Letter and mail we receive. We want to know the details. It's a really an organization to know the details of what? Of mails and letters received in a particular period of time. Another one is what? It tells the organization about the sender of mails. Yes! You know that when you receive a letter or mail from someone, the sender of that mail or letters will be what? The name of that person will be written there. Sometimes an organization can receive information through letters. Abi, you write a letter to another person that your name is written there, so company. Abi, so the organization will know the what? We know the sender of that letters or mail. And if you send mail to another person, your name, the sender of that mail will be what? Will be shown on that what? Mail. So that's another use of what? Inward books. It tells us the organization about the sender. It tells the organization about the sender of the mails. So the organization will be able to know what? The sender of that particular mail. Maybe something happened now. Go to check. What happened? Which organization sent us this particular mail? You can check through your inward books. Because your inward books, it will be a book like this. Sender of that mails. The details of that mails. The date in which the mails what is what? It be what? Will be written on the inward books. Another uses of inward books, it also tells us the dates in which an information is received. Yes. What will be a particular day in which the letter or mail is received? This is another uses of what? Inward books. Exactly to you now. And let's do the second one. The second one is what? Outward books. Outward books is what is opposite of what? Inward books. Outward books is what? Is an office correspondence that shows or is a books. Sorry. Outward books is what is a books. That shows the mail and the letters that is sent out to a particular organization. We call it outward books. So the inward books is a book that is open to show the mail and letter that is received in an organization. And we as an organization sometimes we send letters, we send mail to another organization. It should be written in outward books. So outward books is a book that shows the mail and letter that is what that is sent out or that goes out of an office. Any letters or mail that go out of an office be recorded in what? In outward books. Exactly to you now. Inward books is when the mail and letter that is received that come in into an office. Exactly to you now. What outward books is what? Is the books that show the mail and letter that is sent out or that goes out of an office. Another one is let's look at uses of in outward books. Uses of outward books is written here. The first one is what? It is used by an organization to know the total number of mail or letters that sent out to people. Yes. Maybe we want to know the number of letters and mails we have sent to other people. We want to know it. You can do it through the outward books. You go through the outward books. Let's check it. Okay. So this. We send so information to God. Can you see now? In that outward books, it will have a part. It will have dates in which we send the mail and letters, the details of that letters or mail, and the what? And the sender, and the where we are sending that mail to. The addressee. Addressee is basically that is what? That is receiving that what? Mail. Or the organization that in which we send the mail to. So it shows the total number of mail and letters we send to people or an organization in a particular period or time. Is that clear to you now? Second one is what? It gives details of the sender and receiver of a particular mail. It gives details. Yes. The detail, that is the information we are passing or the details of that letter or mail that you are sending to other people. It shows it that okay, so this we send so information to another particular company. So this we send so information to another organization. Another one is what it shows the date and time the letter will dispatch. After sending letter to a particular what to a particular organization, a particular people, the date in which the letter is sent will be recorded in what outward because outward book the day in which we send the information, letter or mail to a company. Abi, the details will be written there, the dates will be written there. So you know the dates in which the what letters were and the date in which the letter were dispatched. After sending your mail, or let's say you send a mail to an organization. Abi, the day the organization receives that mail will be written on the mail that this person has received the mail, or you send a letter to a particular organization. After giving the person a letter, you also have to give the particular person a book to sign that he has received that letter. So that when you get to the office back, so you what it will be written down on the what outward books. So information, so letter or mail was sent to social organization at this time, and the person received it at so particular
time. So these are the four, these are the what? These are the uses of what? Outward books.
Now, the third one is what? Dispatch book. Dispatch book. Now, dispatch book is a book that is that shows that what? A particular mail or letter has been what? Has been sent to a particular person, or that should have what? A particular what? Letter or mail has been received. Has been what? Has been received by hand by the addressee. So, for example, now this dispatch book is normally used when we what? We send a letter to someone. And that if that letter is what is received by the person that is sent to, he or she has to sign a particular book to fill a form to show that all that letters have been received by him. And this dispatch is normally what issued out, is normally what given to a what a dispatch rider. What you call it, what dispatch rider. Dispatch rider are those people that what that deliver goods to someone. I mean, maybe you send something to someone now. So deliver, you have to give the dispatch rider the person that is what that will take that goods or letters to a particular person. It's called dispatch. They are called dispatch riders. So a particular form will be given, will be what? Will be signed by the addressee to show that what he has received that letter or goods. Exactly. So dispatch book is a book that is used to show that what a particular the addressee, a particular person has what has received a letter or mail, has received a letter by hand. A letter by what? By hand. So this one is normally used to record the what the book that it is normally used to record that certain person has what has received a particular letter by hand, not through mail. So we are leaving a letter to what by hand, we call it a dispatch. So and the last one is what? And the last one is called a postage book. Postage book is normally is a book that is used to what? To shows the that what? To show that what a particular letter or mail has been what has been posted. So we call it what? Postage book. So it's normally used to show that what a particular what mail has been posted. So whenever a what a particular mail has been posted to someone, it will be what? It will be recorded in what in the postage book. So these are the types of this correspondence we have. I will give you a note. The note I will send it to interview. You see it online. So you try to copy your note and you submit. It's very, very important. Take care. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.